Good morning, children. Welcome to the English class. Today we are going to continue with lesson number 7, the poem The Raven and the Fox by La Fontaine. I am sure you all have written the new words and the word bank and A1 and A2 exercises you must have done in your English classwork notebook. I'd asked you to write the answers to questions 1 and 2, but I had asked you to write the answer to question number 3 in your rough notebook. Please open that notebook and just see what you have written. Why do you think the fox preaches moral principles to the raven instead of just running away with the morsel? Now the crow or the Mr. Raven, the raven had dropped the morsel because he opened the beak to sing and the fox got it. Instead of running away with the morsel, he stayed back and taught or preached some moral principles to the raven. Now, why do you think the fox did this? There can be a number of answers. You have to give your own reasons. There's no one correct answer. You could think and write whatever you feel was the reason for the fox to preach moral principles to the raven. You could write that he wanted to prove that the raven was at fault and the fox was not at fault. Now why? Because the raven gave in to flattery. You could even write that he wanted to distract the raven. You could also write that the fox knew that he was doing something wrong, but then he did not want the raven to think that he had cheated him. He wanted to show to the raven that he was the one who gave in to flattery, he was the one who had the vice of vanity, and so he could justify his actions. There can be many more answers. Whatever you think was the reason for him preaching the moral principles to the raven, please write that in your own words, at least 2 to 3 sentences. And after you are satisfied with what you have written, copy that answer in your English classwork notebook. You can discuss it with your friends if you want to. When you call them, you don't have to go to their homes, but you can call them or WhatsApp to them and discuss what they think. Now we come to the last few exercises of this poem. Next one is sounds and pronunciation. Now this time they have concentrated on the sound of the letter combination CH. When CH are together, it has a different sound in different words. CH together may have the K sound. CH together has the CH sound in many words. And CH, if you use this combination, may have the SH sound as well. Now, you must have heard such words. The sound of CH as in chair and such. What do you think is the sound in these words? It's the CH sound, like you have in chair and such, is the most usual way of pronouncing CH. The most usual way is when you see CH in a word, frequently it is the CH sound. But then there are other sounds as well. in the words that are derived from Greek, like you have the words like character, school, the sound of ch is like k. School, school is as if the sound of ch is k. Again, character, ch is as if the sound is the sound of k. Then the sound of ch in words which are drawn from French. That means these words were taken from French, and the sound of ch in such words is the sh sound. Like we have in chef, chef. I hope you all know the meaning of the word chef. Chef means the head cook or a cook in a big restaurant or a big hotel. Then you have the sh sound in machine, machine. Machine and chef has ch, but the sound is sh. So the most common sound of ch is of course ch, which we usually have in many words. But if the words have been derived from Greek, they were originally used in Greek, and then we have taken them from Greek, then the sound of ch is k. And if they were taken from French, then the sound is sh, ch. Now you have a box in which you have a number of words, and below that box you have three columns. The first thing you see are two lines and a letter in between these two slash. The lines are slanted, so they are called slash. So k sound as in school, then sh sound as in chef, and the third column is the ch sound as in chair. Now you will see k is of course k, but then there is some other symbol for the sh sound and two symbols together for the ch sound, which are of course different from these letters ch. Now what are these if there are two lines, slanting lines, and in between you have, these are phonic symbols and these are used to pronounce certain words. And if you are not sure about the pronunciation, you can look at these sounds and decide how to pronounce these. Now the first one of course is k. K is like k sound as in school, then sh sound as in chef, and the ch sound is the last column. Now let us read the words one by one. Please keep a pencil in hand, and as I'm reading, you also try to read it loudly or in your mind and decide in which column to put it. But then the pronunciation has to be correct. Now let us start with the first row of words. The first word is anchor. Anchor. Please put it in one of these columns. Then the second word I'll take chop. Ch. Chop. Have you written it? Good. Now the third word is chicken. We have to just see the sound of ch. Please don't see ck. We are concentrating on the sound of ch. So the third word is chicken. The fourth word, chorus. The fourth word is chorus. The fifth word is chauffeur. The fifth word is chauffeur. The sixth word is champagne. The sixth word is champagne. In chauffeur and champagne, please concentrate on the sh sound. Then the last word here is parachute. The last word is parachute. Excuse me. Now you come to the next row of words. You must have got all these in the correct column by now. Now we come to the next line of words. Cord. Cord. Then the next one, chemist. Third word is Christmas. Have you written these three? Now the fourth word, chaos. The fourth word is chaos. Next word, brochure. The next word is brochure. Then chuckle. Again, you have to see the CH sound and not CK. Chuckle. And the last word in this line is mustache. The last word is mustache. Got all the words? Now the next row of words. Headache. The first word in this line is headache. Then the next one is machinist. The next word is machinist. Then the third word here is architect. The third word here is architect. Then the next one, I'm sure everyone knows, is an organ from your science book, which is found in our body. Stomach. Stomach. Then the next one is very easy again. Much. Cheer. And the last one is echo. And the last one is echo. Got all these words? Now the last ones. The first one in this line is chivalry. The first word in this line is chivalry. The next one, check. The third one, schemes. Now the fourth one is very easy and everyone knows the pronunciation. I think I don't need to read it. But then also I'll read it, rich. Then the next one is a bit difficult. It is chaperones. The next one is sure, chaperones. And the last one is mechanic. Mechanic, of course, everyone knows, one who comes to repair something. And chaperones, have you heard this word? You may have heard it. It means the person who accompanies someone else. He is called your chaperones or a chaperone if he is one. Now I'm sure you must have put all these words in the correct column. Now I'm going to read the words which should be in the first column. K sound. As in school. So you should have the words which have the K sound, and I'll read all the words which have the K sound. First word, anchor. Second, chorus. Third, chord. Fourth one, chemist. Have you got these four? Now we come to the fifth one. Still, we are on the K column. Christmas. The next one, chaos. Then the next one, headache. Architect. Stomach. Echo. Schemes. Mechanic. Now, how many words you have in this column? Please count. I'll give you 1 minute to count. You should have 12 words in this column. I'll repeat the words: anchor, chorus, chord, chemist, Christmas, chaos, headache, architect, stomach, echo, schemes, mechanic. Now the next one is the sh sound, as in chef. The sh sound as in chef. The first word in this column, you should have chauffeur. C-H-A-U-F-F-E-U-R, chauffeur. Then the next one is champagne. Then the third word, parachute. Fourth word, brochure. Fifth word, mustache. The sixth word, machinist. The seventh word, chivalry. And the last one in this column is chaperones. Now I'll repeat the words: chauffeur, champagne, parachute, brochure, mustache, machinist, chivalry, and the last one, chaperones. Now you have the ch sound in the CH words, which is of course the easiest. So I hope and I'm sure almost all the words are correct. The first word, chop. Second, chicken. Third word, chuckle. Fourth word, much. Fifth word, cheer. Sixth word, check. And the last word, rich. Now I'll repeat all the words in this column. First one, chop. Second, chicken. Third, chuckle. Fourth, much. Fifth, cheer. Sixth, check. And the seventh, rich. Now please be sure that you have the words in one of the columns. You can't repeat the word and you can't leave a word. Each word has to be in one of these three columns. And then when you are using it from the box, if you have used it, you can cut it so that you know it is already there in the column and you don't have to repeat it. Now, I hope you all will find a few more words of your own which have the ka sound, which have the sh sound, and which have the ch sound from the dictionary or from books you read, and you can write them below these three columns. At least try to write two words of each sound in your book. You have space, you can write two words below the column for ka, then two words with the sh sound and two with the ch sound. Now we come to the activity section. The first activity is read the famous fable, The Fox and the Grapes by Aesop, and rewrite it in your own words. Now yesterday I told you the poem, The Raven and the Fox by La Fontaine, is based on a fable. Now, what are fables? Yes, fables are short stories with animal characters and have a moral. Now, Aesop was a slave and a storyteller, and he has written a number of fables. But there is no proof to show that it was Aesop only who has written all these fables. It is possible that some other people may have written it and it has been attributed to Aesop. But then we have got these in a book called Aesop's Fables, and most of the people think that these were stories by Aesop. Now, what you have to do is you have to read The Fox and the Grapes. If you have a book of fables, please read it from there. If you don't have, there are a lot of videos and the stories there on net. You go to Google and you'll find it. You read it, but you are not going to copy it in the same words. You can read it, you can watch it and understand it, but then you have to rewrite it in your own words. Now, this fable is very, very short. And you have to just write it down in your own words. Now, you all must have read this. And if you remember it, you can write it without even watching or reading it again. Now, there are a lot of famous fables by Aesop. You have the ant and the grasshopper. You have the boy who cried wolf. You have many, many more. The hare and the tortoise. You have read these stories. The boy who cried wolf. Every time he used to cry wolf, wolf. And the people used to come running to save him. And he used to laugh at them and tell them that it was just a joke. And one day a wolf really came, and then no one came to help him because they thought he was just having fun. Then ant and the grasshopper. Yes, there was an ant who worked hard all the summer, the whole summer, kept on collecting food, storing food for the winter. And the grasshopper was just singing, dancing, enjoying himself. And when it became very cold, there was snowfall all around, the grasshopper did not have anything to eat, while the ant had so much because she had worked hard during summer. And the moral is there, which the ant gives to the grasshopper, that you should work hard and store for the future. Now, The Fox and the Grapes, of course, in just two sentences, the fox goes and sees grapes, bunches of grapes hanging from the vine, V-I-N-E, wants to just pluck these grapes and eat them, but then it cannot reach. And so the fox says that the grapes are not good, they are sour, and there is a moral that when we cannot do something, we don't blame ourselves for not being able to do it. We blame something on that thing. If I'm not able to dance, I can blame the music system. I can blame the other girls who were dancing before me. And the same thing here, the fox does not blame himself that he could not reach the grapes. He says that the grapes were sour. Now please read it properly and write it in your own words in your rough notebook. Now C2, you have to do a little research on your own and answer the following questions. There are three questions. You must have watched these names on TV on internet, but you can do a little bit of research and then write these answers. Now, the first one is, what does it mean if you compare a person to a fox? When someone is compared to a fox, what does that mean? If someone is compared to a fox, what quality does that person have which is similar to that of a fox? We say he's like a fox, or as a fox he did this thing. So which quality do you think that person has that he is compared to a fox? Just think about it. You can do a little research on Google or from books and then write this answer. The second one is very easy. You must have done it in your computer class or read about it in your computer book. What is Mozilla Firefox? You just have to write a few sentences about this. Of course, it is connected or has to do something with computers and net and the computer lesson. Now the third one is, what is 20th Century Fox? Now this name you must have read just before cartoon films start, or even before films, English feature films, Hollywood films, they write, or a big sign comes of 20th Century Fox. You can see this in your book also. On the left, you have the symbol of Mozilla Firefox, and on the right, you have the 20th Century Fox symbol. Now, please do the research. A little research. You don't need to write pages after pages. You just need to write 3 to 4 sentences on each. First, why someone is compared to a fox? What quality does he have that he is compared to a fox? Second, what is Mozilla Firefox? And third one, what is 20th Century Fox? All these answers, that is the fable of the fox and the grapes by Aesop, you will write in short. So it could be just half a page. It is not going to be more than one page. So the fable has to be written in your own words in short, half a page or at the most one page. Then you will do research and write these three. Why a person is compared to a fox, what is Mozilla Firefox, and what is 20th Century Fox. Please write it in your own words. That is all for today, children. Thank you. Till we meet again with another interesting topic. Thank you and take care.